Hey everybody, it's W from MediaCat Media, back with another helpful video. Today we're going to teach you how to back up your videos, your files, your movies, whatever you need, and all for free. Let's get started. Okay, first thing we're going to do is we are going to open up. I'm going to remote into my server. Give me a minute here. And as you can see, I already have FBackup version 9.7 already installed, but I'm going to show you where to go get this and download it. I use this all the time. You can set it up for to schedule your backups. I recommend you do this overnight, depending on how large of the files, the overall content. I utilize this for my Plex server primarily. I also use it to back up and restore any of my website files. I'd also recommend that you back up these files to a completely separate location, right? Think about security, think about, God forbid there's a fire in your house. You should have more than one computer. If you don't, there's a lot of other opportunities. I back these up to my NAS, my Synology NAS. There's another video if you want to watch it. I'll put a link right here. You can back these up to a completely different hard drive, a USB stick, and again, another computer if you have one in your house. Even if your kids have one, you can always do a network and save all of your backup files on somebody else's device. Okay, so let's get started. Let me move this over here a little bit. We're going to open up and go into our Google search. And we're going to type in FBackup download, and it's going to pull it right up on FBackup.com. This again is free software. Just click right here and you'll download it to your, now I'm using Windows 11. So click here, download it, and go ahead and install it. Once you install it, you're going to get this interface. Let me open this up a little bit more. As you can see, I update my website, and that's www.needycatmedia.com. You guys should go check it out. Needy Cat Media merch, along with a lot of other equipment out there for PC builds and so forth. Okay, so first thing we want to do, we want to click on new. This is going to be a new job. We're going to demo this for you. Again, I've done this a couple different times. I always save to a completely different network device, so something completely different. We are going to look at the destination first. So this goes backwards. You don't pick the file and then tell it where to go. You tell it the destination you want the file to go first, and then you pick the file that you want. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to pick my NAS. We're going to pick our folder. Now, I always like to grab and create a new folder. We'll just call this saves. Okay. Go to next. Now it's gonna say, all right, what is it that you wanna back up? So we are just gonna go to our C drive. Okay. We'll go to my public folder. We'll go to downloads. Here, we'll just save this one. This is another great software for you, Real Temp diagnostic software. Grab this one. Just go ahead and click next. We don't want to do any type of password protection here, but you can. You also have the ability to do a full backup or a mirror backup. So we're going to do a mirror backup. Now, read the definition of this. A mirror backup will create in destination the exact copy of the source file without zipping it. If you make a backup, it's going to zip the file. So we're gonna go full. This is great again for pictures, movies, whatever. I'm gonna click next. I'm gonna do a manual, but here you can schedule this. So, you know, if you just wanna do routine backups, which I would highly suggest you do them at least weekly. Some people might say do monthly, annual, whatever. The more frequent, the better. Again, it just depends on how big the files are. We'll do a manual here. We're gonna click next. Personalize, we're just gonna call this backup file. And we're gonna save it. And we're gonna save and run. Now this process could take a few minutes. I'm gonna bring this up and pull this over here so you guys can see it. Here is our folder. We're gonna give it a minute. While we're waiting, if you like this video and you found value in it, please consider subscribing to the channel. Hit that little thumbs up and also go ahead and hit that bell. Okay, now that took a few minutes for it to run, but it was successful. You can see right here, we have the files. If you go into C, which is exactly where we pulled it from the server, then we clicked on users, we clicked on the name, downloads, and then there's the file. So it does follow the entire path, but here is the file and you should be good to go. Okay, gang, thank you so much for watching. Again, this is free software. Don't hesitate to go get it. It's great. I've been using it now for a few years. It's called FBackup. It does come every once in a while with some updates. So keep on it, save your data. As always, stay safe, stay healthy. Take care.